Hi, I'm John Twist of University Motors. We're going to do a speed tune-up, a silent tune-up. That means the engine is running. I'm just going to show you what I'm going to do instead of really doing it, because if it was really doing it, you wouldn't hear anything and the engine shaking and so forth. So the first thing we're doing here for our tune-up is I'm dropping off the air cleaners, right? I mean, that's real straightforward. I got a quarter-inch drive ratchet here with a half-inch socket. These are for a 73B carrying HIF carburetors. These are about 5-inch long coarse thread bolts. You see that the breather holes here at the top of the air cleaner match the breather holes at the top of the carburetor here on the face. That's essential on both of them. Let me put them both down here out of the way, and we have already dropped our evaporative line off the back one. Let's take a look at him. Is he hooked up the same? Yes, he is. The breather holes here. The breather holes here are at the top. That is essential. If that doesn't happen, then the carburetor isn't going to work correctly. Let's take a look at the lines here. We've got our front tappet inspection cover coming through the 12G2134 plastic Y piece and venting into the rear of the rear carb and into the front of the front carb. This is how the engine ventilates through here. If we want to check this and make sure that it's all clear, it's all working okay, we take the valve cover off here. Blow through here, we can hear the air come up through here. I can feel it come up. I know that the front tappet side cover is open. If the front tappet side cover is plugged up, we can cut it open and replace the mesh inside with a Chore Boy polishing pad. Here's our vent here for the float bowls. That goes over to the charcoal canister over on that side. The charcoal canister, then the air from the charcoal canister is drawn into the engine here. We've got a line that goes to our anti-run-on valve from the intake manifold, and we have a line that goes from the intake manifold, usually not here, it's usually over on the side, down to our distributor on this side. Remember that our tune-up is four links in the chain: emissions, as great or as slight as they are, engine, ignition, and finally carburation. So in this case, when we're talking about the engine, we want to make sure that our compression is the same on all four cylinders. Our spark plugs are Champion N9Ys, number 415s, that's an RN9YC. Champion plug, do not use iridium plugs, don't use platinum plugs, just use old-fashioned Champion N9Y plugs, you'll be much happier. NGKs, those are all right too. We want to make sure that our vacuum advance is working, our mechanical advance is working. We want to make sure that our maximum timing on the front pulley is 32 degrees vacuum disconnected. That's a real critical number, 32 degrees. We want to make sure our valve train is all adjusted the same, and you know that our thermostat is working and the temperature comes up. We want to make sure we got at least half a tank of fresh gasoline in the tank, and then we're over to our carburetors. Let me show you about the carburetors. First of all, the most handy thing you can do is replace the lock nuts with these springs. See these adjuster springs? The outboard screw, this one, that's your idle adjustment. The inboard screw is your fast idle adjustment. Take those lock nuts off and get AUC 2451 springs. They are so nice. And you can also get 8483, AUC 8483 adjuster screws. These are available from Joel Curto, among lots of other people. So anyway, the first thing we do is start the car up, rev it up, ram, 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 okay? And you'll give me a pass here if I make engine noises. And then we're gonna put our unison on each carburetor, fiddle with the dial on the unison so that our plastic piece sits about in the middle, and make sure that each carburetor is drawing the same amount of air and it's idling around 800 RPM. If we've got a raise or lower, one or both, okay, then we use the adjuster screws. Work back and forth between every single adjustment you make, rev it up and blow it out. Ram, ram, ram. And let the thing come back down. So now we're idling. We got the same amount of air going through each carburetor, and it's idling around 800 RPM. So now we go to check the mixture. We can use the piston lifting pin, which you got to stick your finger down the side. See how it lifts the air piston here? Okay. You can either lift the piston lifting pin, or what I like to do is put a screwdriver through here, rotate the screwdriver, and lift the piston here. You can move back and forth really easily. You don't have to stick your finger way underneath where it doesn't fit very nicely. One of three things is going to happen when you lift the air piston. The RPM is going to be coming along, and if the carburetor is adjusted too rich, the RPM is going to climb the higher you lift the piston. Or if it's too lean, as soon as you begin to lift the piston, the RPM falls right off. What you're looking for is 50 RPM. You're looking, as you just begin to lift the piston, the RPM rises and then it falls away. So we lift the front piston, for instance, okay? And it goes higher, geez, the higher we lift the piston, the faster it runs. It's way too rich. So we take our idle adjuster screw out here and we turn him anti-clockwise. We turn him counterclockwise, and maybe we turn him counterclockwise by a whole turn. Okay, that makes him lean. Clockwise is rich. Okay, so we go by full turns in the beginning. After every single adjustment, ram ram, rev it up, blow it out. You make full turn adjustments until you pass the point where it's correct. Then we make half turn adjustments and finally quarter turn adjustments. Then we can go to the back one and do the same thing. While you're doing this, you're going to make the car run more efficiently. So now it's going to run faster than it was before. So now our 800 RPM idle's risen to 1200. So we got to go back to our idle adjuster screws and back those off the same amounts. You keep working back and forth until each piston raises the RPM 50 and then falls off, and the thing's idling 800 RPM, or whatever idle you want. There's nothing magic about 800. You can have it idling at 600, although that's real way too low for me, and you can have it idling at 1000. It depends who's driving the car. Then you want to make sure that the fast idle is the same. So you take your unison and you put it on here, and you work your fast throttle, okay, and you put it on here. When you go to lift this, you lift this guy until he's running the fastest. Okay, let's say that's about right there. And you check it back and forth, and you find out that one of them's open a whole lot more than the other. Then you go ahead and adjust your little screws on the inboard side. So they're both drawing the same amount of air, and it's running at about 1600 RPM. That's when it's running the fastest. Doesn't matter if you pull it all the way up or you barely touch it. Wherever it runs the fastest. Then shut the car off and come back out and move your throttle here. And you want to make sure that just as you begin to lift the throttle, that both the throttles, front and rear, open at exactly the same time. Here you've taken all this time to make this adjustment. You want to make sure that the fingers, which are controlled by these guys here, don't open one of the throttles way too soon. You're all done here. You can go out and test drive it. Go out and run the thing really hard. When that's done, put the air cleaners back on, go out and drive it again. You can still make your adjustments with the air cleaners on. You can make adjustments on the road. So, four links in a chain: emissions, engine, ignition, carburation. Emissions, you can't plug stuff up. You know, I talk to people, they say, oh yeah, I got all my stuff all blocked off. Well, some stuff you can't block off and have the car run right. This is the way it's supposed to be. Engine, that's your valve clearance, your compression, clean engine oil, your thermostat, your spark plugs. Oh, I know spark plugs are part of the ignition, but you know they're in the engine, so I always include them in there. Your ignition, that's your point gap, 15 thousandths, your timing, 32 degrees maximum, and finally over here on the carburation, both both carburetors, two carburetors, each one's got to act exactly the same as the other. When you're all done, should run like a dream, okay? And the whole process here, tuning the carburetors, shouldn't take you more than 10, 15 minutes, you know? If it's taking you longer than that, walk away, come back to it. And remember that if the car is really, really rich, you can load up your spark plugs, and then it starts to run on three cylinders. That's why I'm suggesting that you rev it up between every single adjustment that you make. Hey, good luck, safety fast, see you on Thursday.